special review. This one was originally going to be an unboxing, but I did the recording and I lost the footage, so I don't know how that happened, but this time it'll be the Nerf Zombie Strike. This is one I've been waiting for a long time. Zombie Strike, Sling Fire. See, I already have it out of the box, it's right there, which I had it for about a week. And so we're just going to take a quick look at the box first. You can see we've got Zombie Strike here, we've got Sling Fire, cautions and all that, cartoon dude, the Sling Fire holding it like pum pum pum. All zombie background, lever action, blasting, Nerf. And this is actually the second Nerf gun to have clip system, the first one being the new Z-Squad Longshot CS-12. There's that, check out the Nerf Zombie app, if it ever comes out, check it out. Just grab the blaster, this is how it's stored in, it came in like that, actually, like that. Ages Aiden up, Hasbro down there somewhere. On the back we've got the sketch layout thing, the cartoon dude again. How to load the gun, how to prime it, and yeah. Lever action blasting, pull trigger to fire, swing lever to cock or flick the blaster to cock it with one hand, 6-dart clip, which is right here, with 6-dart zombie strike darts. And I brought a 12-dart clip from my retardator as well, just to test it out. Zombie strike again, and here, mission, clear the area completely, target zombies, zombies everywhere. Whoa. Pause it there if you want to read it. Time's up. So there's the box, I'll never need that again. So on to the main attraction, the Sling Fire. This is the new lever action gun from Zombie Strike Land. So we'll start out with what's on the blaster. The front, it's got no in strike attachment bell, so you can't put bell extensions on. It's got the tactical rail and the jam port right here, so you can get your jams. There, it's got 9 sight on the front, you know, and guiding rails on top, so you can line it up like that. You can kind of see it there. Yeah, like that. And it's got 2 sling adapters up here. I like the bandage style here and on the handle, it's very comfortable. It's a nice clean black as well with the green. You've got Sling Fire here, Nerf, the Zombie Strike logo on the stock. And I like how they did the stock to make it look like a nice wood texture, but doesn't feel like it's just plastic. We've got the magwell here, clip release, the trigger, and the lever. You see, just pull down like that and loose your shoot. And it comes, like I mentioned before, it comes with the 6-dart clip. So how you fire it, how you load the blaster, you just prime it forwards, put in your 6-dart clip, if I can get it in. Like that, pull it back, then pull the trigger, like that. Some of these darts might not work as well, but I'll show you the Zombie Strike darts. So they're just green elite darts, nothing new there. And then to prime it, you just go like that, pull the trigger, like that. You can also do one-handed priming, so you just flick it down and then back up, so like that, which I'll show you in a firing demo, which I will do very shortly. So with the 6-dart clip, the normal 6-dart clip's the new Instruct Elite version. Here's the 12-dart retaliator clip with it. So you can see it's about half the size. I'll be firing off the retaliator clip as well as this one. And how you just load the mag, you just push, like you push one down, push a dart in, push the next one down, and you just repeat the process there. Some of these ones have been stressed a bit, so you might be a bit wrecked in these ones. Other than that, that's basically it. I do want to make one comment though. There will be a couple of updates coming soon on my channel. I'll have a new camera, hopefully, rather than this one. And that's basically about it. Keep out my for the next Mega Magnus one. Be hopefully the next one. Enough of that, let's just continue with this one. It's got instructions on the side, so how to prime it. See, right there. and got all the screw ports on this side, nothing on this side, as you can plainly see. And that's basically it. It's a direct plunger system, if you can see in there. Direct plunger. And it's on a kind of like guarding rail. So if I open up the jam door, you can see it's on a guarding rail. So it slides through on this axis and then through. It's got an air restrictor built in as well. See the air release hole about there. And what we're going to do now is we're going to shoulder and fire this thing. So let me get the clips ready and we'll come back to you. Okay, so I've got the clips ready and the sling fire is ready. So we're going to fire the 12 dart one off first. Set these down. So again, when you load it, just prime it forwards. Slide the clip in. And one thing I did not mention before, this is compatible with any mag system. Any mag, so you can put a rampage drum in there, the banana clip from the demolisher, anything in there. You can't put like the mega ones on there. And that's how it looks like with the retaliator clip on. So the stock is comfortable as well. It's nice and comfy. You can really get up there. So we're gonna fire a couple, if it will fire. It hasn't fired a couple times. See, it's got jam in there already. This thing does like to jam a lot though, and it's good to use the jam drill. So we'll just let that one fall out. Do this again. This could take a while, so you can skip ahead this video if you want to. We'll just put it back in again, and let's try again. Starting from the red marker. Let's try again. Oh, come on. Here it's still playing up in there. See, we've got a dart in there. We'll see if that one will fire by itself. And it will not, so we're going to have to pull this one out. So we're going to be a cheat and put this in like this. Do like this, then fire it. There we go, that one actually fired. And a dart fell out the clip here. And I'm sitting down and up, sitting down. This one better not jam as well, hopefully. I'm not going to do flat and angle shots this time, just because. There we go, shot another one, lever forward. So you prime it again, forward, back, pull the trigger. So you take it out, you prime it, pull the lever back, pull it out, because you try and pull it out here, you can't pull it out, try to pull the mag well, it won't pull it out. Prime it forwards, can't pull it out like that, you have to push it in and it will come out. So there's that, we'll put our 6 dart clip in now, which hopefully should work this time. And this looks makes it look a lot better this time, more compact, much better. We're going to do 3 of the normal and then 3 of the sling action and see how it goes. I think we might have a jam again. My god, we do have a jam. This could take a while, so skip ahead if you want. There's actually, I think there might actually be 2 darts stuck in there. Yes, there is. There's 2 darts stuck in there. Now, you can skip ahead if you want to, but if you're like me in videos, I choose not to, unless they're really boring videos. So once again, there'll be updates coming soon, a new camera, which will hopefully be my video camera sunglasses, which is same video format as this, but this is higher to view, so, well, to video, so there's 2. 3, we're going to do sling action now. Wait for this truck to go past. And back on. Sling it. See if I show you here. Sling it. Nothing playing. playing with this for a long, long time. This is a really good gun. I've been playing like this. I've been doing that for ages. Put this down here, we'll go see where those darts are. There was a couple of dud shots here, so there's one here. Another one there. Got elite dart. Not elite dart, zombie strike dart. Elite, zombie strike, and more, elite, and elite, zombie strike. That one I think might actually be the furthest one, so you think that's actually pretty far. But I think that last one was an angled shot. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yep, so only one zombie strike that I left to find. And I'll get back to you while I'm back at my seat. Okay, so the clips have been all filled up again. So now we're going to do the pros and cons of this gun. First off, the pros. It's a lever action blaster, so you can go prime really fast. You don't have to move it a lot because the stock is really comfortable. It's the first one with a clip system, which is really good. So you can put any mag in, the drum mag from the Rampage or the 35 one from the Raider, Retaliator one, that one there. The sights are really good, you can kind of see. They're very accurate, it's very accurate, I must say. Better than a Retaliator, I reckon. You can do many tricks with it. Right. But sometimes when you're priming it, so moving on to now the cons of this gun. The cons, sometimes when you're priming it, like you're flinging it down, it doesn't click all the way. It's supposed to get that click there to be able to come back. If you just go there and you can't pull back, you have to go that click and then come back and fire it. It jams quite a bit because of this in here. No barrel attachment, which would look really nice, I reckon, with a Retaliator barrel on, I reckon. So that has been my review of the Nerf Zombie Strike Slingfire. Recap, it is a really good gun. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.